Hello friends, Namaskar. Being a senior citizen is a matter of respect and it is a matter of pride. But at the same time, the senior citizenship along with it brings a lot of tussle, a lot of struggle in terms of financial independence of such person. So this financial independence question becomes very important when the senior citizen does not have a regular source of income like pension or interest income. In such a scenario, how the reverse mortgage scheme could be beneficial to such person, this is what today I have brought in summarized manner before you. So my dear friends, why reverse mortgage? Because the reverse mortgage is the only scheme which provides an opportunity to the person who is a senior citizen, rather than selling the property in which he is residing, to convert it in form of certain loans. And such loans could be monthly amount, could be a quarterly amount, could be a half yearly amount, which that person would receive from the bank. And such amount would keep on accumulating along with interest. And there is also no responsibility of such person as such to pay off unless he has the funds to pay off such particular amount. Rather, the senior citizen would be enjoying those particular payments which are made in installment to him. And that is why this particular scheme is called as reverse mortgage scheme. Because in a reverse mortgage scheme, as compared to a normal mortgage, when you mortgage a property, you take one-time loan and you repay the EMIs. Here, there is no concept of EMI. If I can put these particular understandings in form of certain written expression, then I would read it as reverse mortgage is a funding scheme under which financial institution like bank, etc. evaluate the value of a property owned by the senior citizen borrower, and based on such value provides monthly, quarterly, half yearly payment towards the living cost of such person. In such loan, however, interest on the amount disbursed from time to time is capitalized and realized along with the principal at the time of final payment or on the recovery of loan at the time of death of the borrower. Say for an example, a person with the age of 65 years who doesn't have the sources of funds for his own maintenance or the maintenance of he himself with his spouse can go to a banker, say that, look, I have a property valuing rupees 1 crore rupees. Can you fund me some amount on this? Now the bank may evaluate that property on its own. Say for example, the bank values the property for rupees 70 lakh. And now the bank may thinks of that, okay, under the reverse mortgage scheme, since this person requires on a monthly basis 20,000 rupees for the maintenance of himself and his wife, so bank may accept a proposal of reverse mortgage, and under that particular proposal, the bank may further at the time of such particular loans disbursement take off with 20,000 rupees monthly payment to such person. So therefore, as I said in the beginning, this is a very important scheme under which you can convert your property into an income generating. I would not say that what you are receiving is income, but basically what you are receiving is towards your maintenance. A very big question is now coming in the mind of the senior citizen viewers that, okay, if I avail this particular manner, then what are the subsequent consequences? My dear friends, I'll discuss those particular consequences further. So as per the initial background which I have given to you, what are the essentials of a reverse mortgage? There are three very important points. The borrower should be a senior citizen, that is 60 years or plus age. She or he should be owner of a property, and I can say it should be a residential property. And the property should be free of any kind of encumbrances or charge. So there should not be any charge on the property. If these three things are there, then you are prima facie eligible for offering your property under reverse mortgage scheme. Now let me put up before you some key features as per RBI guidelines. If you will go back in the history of the reverse mortgage, you will find that the scheme of reverse mortgage was first approved by RBI, or it was introduced by RBI in 2007. However, it has not been a great success in India till date, because maybe Indian parents are more interested in handing over the property to their sons and daughters, even if they might not serve to them. But if you see it as an essential source of generating the living amount which is required to a senior citizen couple, it is a very important feature. The age of the borrower should be 60 years or above. However, co-borrower being a spouse should be above 58 years. The property should be residential property. The property should be permanent primary residence of such borrower. 60% of the property value would be the highest loan amount. Yet, I must say that the value of the property, as I said in the example, say is 1 crore in the opinion of that senior citizen. Bank values it 2 rupees 70 lakh. Out of that 70 lakh, bank would fund maximum within a tenure of 10 to 15 years, 60% say 42 lakh, because bank has to also recover that particular amount along with interest. Certain other features, tenure of the loan, as I said, would range between 10 to 15 years. Loan can be disbursed monthly, quarterly, half yearly or yearly as per the requirement of senior citizen. Every 5 years, the property revaluation should be done or should be obtained by the banker. And the interest rate on the loan can be either fixed rate or can be a floating rate. See, a very important question here would come in the mind of the senior citizen person that, look, if I am obtaining a particular loan under reverse mortgage scheme, then how the repayment would take off and how would I make that particular repayment, because I don't have any source of that particular repayment. The source of the repayment, gentlemen, is that particular property itself only. Either during the tenure of the continuance of the loan, you may think of selling of the property. So you approach to the bank. The bank will give you that, okay, till date we have disbursed so much amount along with the interest so much so and due. So you sell off the property, whatever you realize from the property, first pay off to the bank, the balance is yours. Say you are not in a position to pay at all. And a very important question would be coming, like, say, if a person survives even beyond 10 years, 15 years, then what will happen? I'll be answering that particular thing also. So another question is, say, if a person dies, then in that case, the property would be either taken care of by the close kith and kin of that person, maybe those who are inheriting that property, they may pay off that particular loan. Or if the bank ultimately could not realize that particular property, realize that particular loan at all, then bank would sell the property, realize the amount from the property, then recover first its loan along with the interest, and the remaining amount would be paid off by the bank to the legal heirs of that particular senior citizen who has then deceased. What are the tax implications of a reverse mortgage? It is a very important question. Whether the periodic payments are loan or income? A very genuine question. A senior citizen may ask me that, okay, Mr. Bhatia, you suggested me to avail a reverse mortgage. Let's assume, avail it. And now there are monthly disbursements, say rupees 20,000. Are they my income? My answer is no, sir. It is not your income. What you are receiving from the bank is the loan in bits and pieces. Another question. Since that particular loan would attract the interest, whether that interest which will be due on the loan can be claimed as deductible amount under income tax provisions? The answer is, it is not a home loan, it is a home equity loan. So in my opinion, that particular interest, unless used in a business, amount unless used in a business, that cannot be claimed as deductible. Whether any capital gain tax liability shall arise if the property is sold to recover the dues? My answer here is, sir, if you sell off the property in your lifetime as a senior citizen, capital gain tax liability would arise in your hand. If you don't do so and your legal heirs sell off the property or the bank sell off the property after your death, then the tax liability would come on the part of the legal heir to the extent such particular estate is capable of meeting such tax liability. Yet I discussed this particular question in some bits in my previous slides, but I would again put it up before you. How reverse mortgage amount is paid off? Whether it needs to be paid off at the time of maturity? If you as a senior citizen are in position now to pay off at the time of maturity, you can take off that particular option. But if you are not able to do so, or if a person outlives the tenure of the loan, then bank will not compulsorily ask you to make the payment of the loan. You can now sit with the property, you can continue to enjoy the property. Once you don't survive, then the bank will be able to recover that particular amount of loan. Another question, what if the borrower dies before the completion of the loan tenure? In that case, if there is a co-borrower, then that particular co-borrower can continue the further payments and the co-borrower can continue to keep living in the property. What if the property realizes higher amount than the loan and interest? As I said earlier, if the property ultimately sold is realizing higher amount than the outstanding loan and interest, then same shall be remitted back to the legal heir of such person. And if the amount is lower, then in that case, I can say primarily the bank would be able to recover the amount of loan and interest only with the property which is mortgage to it and not beyond that. I think, my dear friends, today's video on the reverse mortgage scheme could be an important input to you, particularly for creating awareness amongst the senior citizen around you, so that if in need, they can avail the benefit of this kind of a scheme, which would certainly be beneficial to them. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.